You've made a return to the national team, two games now in succession. The results didn't go as we had hoped from the beginning, but still a lot to build on. As you rightly said after the game in Mexico, your team keep believing. You still feel that way, obviously?
As I said before, you know, once we keep believing, keep trusting in the Lord Jesus Christ, it's still possible that, you know, we can still qualify. There's still 5 games to go. There's still 15 points to play for. Yes, we know it's not going to be easy. As I said, nothing good in life comes easy. And as I say, it's just a challenge for us that, you know, we give it our all in the last 5 games, and with God's help, you never know what can happen. So I really believe that we still have a great chance of qualifying for this 2010 World Cup Finals. Yes, as I said, the two results didn't go the way that we wanted it. You know, as I say, home to Costa Rica and away to Mexico. But as I say, this is how it goes sometimes. But we just have to keep believing, keep trusting, work harder. As I say, try to eradicate some of the mistakes that we made, learn from the past 2 games, and move on to the next game that is coming.
How you felt though? I mean, it's the first time in Mexico that we've been able to put up such a fight. We were 1 goal away from getting a result, and we had them not so much with their backs against the wall, because the fact that they scored very early in both halves. But for some stages in the game, we actually had them worried.
Oh yeah, it shows that, you know, the progress that we have made. And as I say, you know, credit to the manager. You know, he have the team for a very short time. The team haven't played much, you know, match practice games together and stuff like that, and you know, in such a short space of time, you know, we have really, you know, tried our best to gel together. We still know that we still can gel better, we still can get, you know, because new players are coming through, and you know, it takes time. But unfortunately, the manager don't have time to do, and you know, we showed it in spells in Costa Rica game, and we showed it in spells against Mexico away, which is one of, you know, a hard game to go, a hard place to go in the Azteca. Many times Trinidad and Tobago teams have gone there and been humiliated in such a way, you know, by huge margin of defeat. But you know, it's really, really good for us to go there, put in a solid performance. Yes, you know, we, you know, the team played, you know, well enough. I'd say Mexico had a lot of chances, but you know, good save, some ins, and you know, play sometimes on the team. So, but it's good, and it shows, as I said, things to work with for the last 5 games. And we can take the positive, you know, learn from the mistakes that we have made in those last 2 games, and try to, you know, put it right for the next 5 games coming up.
On that note, how critical is it now, the next 2 months we have before August 12th at home to El Salvador? We need to go all out for that game, obviously.
Oh, definitely. It's at home, as I said, I think it's more crucial than the game that, you know, against Costa Rica at home. As I say, you know, we need to, you know, pick up 3 points from this game, give it all our best, as I say, you know, keep praying, keep trusting God, and know it's really, really crucial. And these are the times that, you know, the bigger the battle, as people say, the sweeter the victory. So I really believe that, you know, with the caliber of players that we have, the young players that are coming through, and, you know, the experienced players, we can really, you know, go there and, you know, between now and August the 12th, I know the manager will have, you know, loads of things in plan and proper preparation for this August the 12th game, because it will be one of the biggest games, you know, for Trinidad and Tobago in the history, on our, you know, on our quest and our desire to qualify for the 2010 World Cup Finals.
How important it is now that the manager, I mean, we've been through these kind of things before. The Federation has from time to time changed the coaches at critical points. He's coming to the job, as he said, toward the hardest games you could have wanted or hoped for, coming on the job for this campaign, Costa Rica, Mexico. How important is it that we maintain this belief in him and give him that opportunity, that support to continue on the job?
It's really very, very important, because, you know, as I said, you know, he has done it, you know, at every level, you know, on his playing time. And I'd say now, you know, he's actually in a different situation and different circumstances, being there actually the head coach and not actually out at the park, you know, doing his magician and his tricks, as, you know, what people call him, the little magician. But as I say, he's in a different role at this moment, where he's on the sideline. He can't do it himself as he used to do, you know, years ago, and, you know, even, you know, latter part of his career. But as I say, it's so important that they give him the chance to continue to maintain what he has already built, what he's, you know, he's getting from his players. And as I say, you know, with more time, it would be perfect for him. But unfortunately, he don't have that time in a short space of time with these 5 games to be coming up. Because as I say, by the time, you know, the ending of this year, we'll know if we are qualifying for the 2010 World Cup Finals or not. So it's really, really important and really, really critical that, you know, they keep Russell Atopi on as best as they can. As I say, that's not my field. As I say, it's up to the TTFF and whoever is in charge on that field, if they desire to keep, you know, Russell on. But I fully believe that they should, because of what he have really started in the two games that he has got. Yes, he didn't get the results that he wanted, but I think that there are loads of things to work with, loads of positive, loads of things to take for from the game. Also, the negative to learn from us, but that become stronger and as a better as a team and a country and a whole as a footballing nation.
You think he has that from the players, the commitment that he needs now from his players? Has he developed that sort of coach-player relationship that is necessary?
Yeah, definitely. He has actually done that because, as I say, he has been a player before. He know what players like. He know what a player can be. He know what it takes to get to the highest level and, you know, to compete at the highest level. He was there in the 2006 squad when we qualified, you know, for our first ever World Cup, and he know what it takes. He know the dedication and the hard work and the persistence and the trials that you face as a footballer, you know, in the quest to reach that dream and that goal, you know. So I believe that, you know, he's getting the feedback from what he wants from the players. He's getting the players to fight for him, to work their end, and, you know, as I say, unfortunately, mistakes has been the main, you know, downfall of these past two games for Trinidad and Tobago international team. We have made crucial mistakes in crucial times of the game that has cost us, you know, in both of these games. So I believe that, you know, if we eradicate these mistakes and these errors, I believe that, you know, from the commitment that we have that the manager is getting from the players and the desire to go out there and win and give their all for Trinidad and Tobago national team and for the jersey and for the country, I can't see no reason why in the last five games we can really pull off a dramatic comeback and, you know, really push all the way to take Trinidad and Tobago to the 2010 World Cup finals.
All right. Final question, Marv. Well, now we know you head back to Scotland in another week or so. How are things looking there? Now you're back. You've played international football again. You go back into the clubs. What can we look forward to?
To look forward to see where Marvin Ant is actually going to be signing. At this moment in time, I'm not connected to a club at this moment in time. As I say, I've been praying and seeking God, asking him for direction to lead me to the right club that he wants me to play at, you know, back in Scotland there. So I'm going back up, you know, a week from now. I'm going to go back and, you know, keep praying to God, keep seeking God. And as I say, eventually I know God is going to lead me to the right club that he wants me to play for next season. So all I can say to you all, you know, keep looking on the internet, keep looking on the papers, and, you know, you're going to hear that, you know, Marvin Andrew signed for somebody, because I believe that, you know, God has, you know, brought me back, you know, playing. As I say, I'm only actually playing back, you know, fully fit, you know, 4 months now, or 4 months going on 5 months, you know. So it's all a miracle for me, and that I'm back playing now, and thanks to God that, you know, I'm back international team and into getting back to the highest level, getting back to my full fitness. So at this moment in time, I'm just going to go back, see where God leads me to. At this moment, I don't have an actual club at this moment in time. I'm just praying, and I know that God will lead me to the right club. So as I said to you, you just have to look at the papers, the internet, or, you know, hear it from somebody as well.
All the very best, Marvin.
Thank you very much.